Hello, my name is Dennis McCormac, and I'm the Director for Genomic Services and Technology Assessment here at the Ontario Genomics Institute, but also for the Center for Applied Genomics at the Hospital for Sick Children. If someone shares DNA, that's either by kissing or a drink, how long does the other person's DNA stay in your body for? Well, there's been research going on about this, and actually, in passionate kissing, it's known to last for about an hour, tops. And that sort of makes sense, because when you think about our mouth being sort of an orifice where things sort of can attack us, it's a really great area for evolution to have defense mechanisms so we protect ourselves against foreign, invasion by something. So having DNAs that break down foreign DNA is really a great thing. And maybe there's identifiers to if it's free flowing in our mouth that will break it down. But what's interesting is there's a whole new area of diagnostics, sort of in pediatric diagnostics, that's starting to occur, because DNA from the fetus can float around into the mother's bloodstream, and we can actually start looking at that DNA to look for diagnosis of whether that child is carrying disease. So that's kind of interesting. So the DNA would last a lot longer in the mother's bloodstream.